good morning students, welcome to the basic electrical engineering lectures. I am Mr. Nagaraj DC, assistant professor EEE BMS IT&M. So in this lecture we will be discussing about RC series circuit. In the previous video lecture we have discussed about RL series circuit. Hope you have found it useful in understanding the nature of electric circuits when connected to the alternating current supply. Okay. So in this lecture we will deal with RC series circuit, yeah, and we'll see how the phasor relations between E and I, what is the power consumptions, what is the power consumption in the RC circuit, and all the aspects of fundamentals of RC circuit. Okay. RC series circuit, as the name itself suggests, it is a series circuit with R and C components connected in series across the supply of E volts. This capital E represent the RMS value of the source voltage. Capital I represent the RMS value of the circuit current. So here the resistive component can be an external component connected in the circuit, or it can be an implicit resistance or equivalent resistance which is present with respect to the capacitance component itself. So practically it is difficult to get a pure capacitance. Therefore RC circuit is the more practical capacitive circuit when compared to the pure capacitive circuit. Okay, so here we observe that the supply voltage E is a sinusoidal voltage. So let us take E is equals to Em sin omega t. So the initial phase angle of the supply voltage is 0. It means that I am taking voltage from the reference axis. It starts at omega t is equals to 0. So Em sin 0 is 0. Em sin 90 is Em. Sin 90 is 1. Therefore, I consider the voltage to be existing from omega t equals to 0 degrees. And by knowing the nature of the circuit, we have already seen in the pure circuit that in capacitor the current will be leading the voltage by an angle 90 degrees. If the capacitor is a pure capacitor, there are no any other elements in the circuit, then the leading angle of the current will be 90 degrees. But since there is resistance present in the circuit, the leading angle of the current may not be 90 degrees, it will be less than 90 degrees. Okay. So we have discussed in the previous lecture that the minimum possible phase angle between voltage and current is 0, maximum possible phase angle between voltage and current is 90 degrees. So the phase angle between voltage and current will lie between 0 and 90 degrees. If it is pure resistive in nature, it will be 0 degrees. If it is pure reactive in nature, it will be 90 degrees, either leading or lagging depending upon whether it is a capacitor or inductor respectively. So here the current in this circuit I will be leading the voltage E by an angle which is less than 90 degrees. I consider it to be phi. Therefore I is equals to Im sin omega t plus phi, you can observe here, because it is the leading current. Since I have taken my voltage to be present at reference, I take current to be leading by an angle phi with respect to the voltage. Okay. So here the moment current flows in the circuit, the voltage drop across resistance will appear, and ER is given by I into R. Okay, by Ohm's law. And EC is the voltage across capacitor is given by I into XC. Actually the voltage across capacitor is not a drop, it is the voltage that is charged by the capacitor plates. Okay, but when the voltage is charged across the capacitor plates, the left plate will be of positive potential, right plate will be of negative potential during positive half cycle and reverse during negative half cycle. Hence we say that the voltage across capacitor or the charged voltage of capacitor will be usually in opposite direction to that of the source voltage. Hence I can conveniently represent the voltage across capacitor as the voltage drop for my analysis across capacitor, considering XC to be the reactance of this capacitor. Therefore the voltage across capacitor is given by EC equal to I into XC, whereas the reactance of the capacitor or inductor we consider in analogous with the resistance to represent the voltage across this capacitor similar to the voltage drop across the resistor, so that I can obtain a very convenient linear equation for my analysis. Now apply KVL to the circuit. By applying KVL to the circuit, okay, we are having three components, so we will get three voltage drops. So it will be E minus ER minus EC is equals to 0. Okay. So by observing this equation, it appears to be algebraic, because in the definition of KVL we have defined in the first unit that the algebraic sum of all voltages and voltage drops in a loop is equal to 0. But going further to AC circuits, it cannot be only algebraic sum, it can also be the vector sum. Okay. Therefore, since I have defined the voltage as a vector, current as also the vector, this equation will be a vector. It is not a scalar. Therefore, E, ER and EC are the vectors. Therefore, I can write E is equals to ER plus EC. Okay. Now, for this equation 3, I should be drawing the phasor diagram for the circuit so that I can get the resultant E. And from that phasor diagram, it will be evident that current is leading the voltage by an angle phi. So at the end of the phasor diagram analysis, we will again see what is the relation, phasor relation between the current and voltage in the circuit. So I consider current to be the reference vector, because in the previous lecture I have told that in any circuit, when I want to draw the phasor diagram, the reference vector should be of a representing a quantity which remains common in all the elements. So this is a series circuit. Current I is common in all the three elements. Hence, current I is taken to be the reference vector in drawing the phasor diagram for this series circuit. Okay. So please remember, whenever we draw phasor diagram for any circuit, we usually consider the common quantity that is across all flowing through or existing across all the components is taken to be the reference vector. So here current is common because it is series circuit. I consider current to be the reference vector for this circuit. Okay. And now I know that this current I is flowing through R as well as C. So same current I is flowing through R as well as C. So the moment current I flows through R, okay, it creates a voltage drop across it is ER, which is equal to I into R. Now this voltage drop is appearing across the resistance. Now remember, what is the phasor relation between the current and voltage across the resistance? Okay. So when we draw the phasor diagram, we will be drawing each vector across each component with respect to reference vector. Then at the end, we will be taking the resultant vector. Okay. So please don't make mistake of remembering the phasor diagram for the entire circuit and then drawing it at once, because if one vector is drawn wrong, then the entire phasor diagram is incorrect and all the marks allocated for phasor diagram will be lost. So the easiest and the correct way to draw the phasor diagram is not to remember and draw it in the form of a diagram. It has to be understood how the phasor relations are existing across each component with respect to the reference vector, then coming to the resultant vector. Okay. So here current is the reference vector. I consider it to be the reference vector. The current I flows through the resistance R. This current is creating a voltage drop across the resistance ER. Okay. So now only observe this resistive component to be a pure resistance circuit with a voltage across it as ER, current through it as I. Therefore, we already know the phasor relation in pure resistive circuit, that the current in R is always in phase with the voltage across the R. But already I have the current vector. Therefore, now I have to place the voltage vector with respect to this current vector. So voltage across R will be in phase with the current through R. Therefore, the vector ER, which is equal to I into R, should be in phase with the current I. So I will be drawing that vector ER overlapping on the current vector I. So this red vector represent the voltage drop across resistance, and I represent the current through resistance. The overlapping of these two vectors represent that voltage ER is in phase with current I. Okay, the same current I now will flow through the capacitance C, and it will charge the capacitor to a voltage EC. Because the nature of supply is sinusoidal, the voltage across capacitor charged will also be sinusoidal. Okay, but now we can observe this capacitance to be a pure capacitance, okay, through which the current flowing is I amperes and the voltage across C is EC volts. Now from the pure circuit analysis, we can remember that the voltage and current have a phase relationship across a capacitor such a way that current through capacitor will always lead the voltage across capacitor by an angle 90 degrees. Okay? But eventually, the voltage across capacitor lag behind the current through capacitor by an angle 90 degrees. Why? Because the current will exist in the capacitor the moment switch is closed, but the voltage which is a changing voltage changing voltage is opposed by the capacitor. So the nature of capacitor is to oppose the change in the value of voltage. Therefore, any moment the current the voltage starts changing, it starts getting opposed, the change is getting opposed by the capacitor. Therefore, the voltage will be continuously lagging behind the current by an angle 90 degrees. Therefore, here from this circuit, the voltage across capacitor is EC, current through capacitor is I. Hence, the voltage EC will be lagging behind the current I by an angle 90 degrees. So, in this vector, we observe voltage EC is lagging behind the current I by an angle 90 degrees. So I draw this vector EC at the end of ER because I want to add ER and EC. We know how to add the vectors graphically. We know how to add the vectors analytically. Okay, so here I will be using the graphical method of adding the vectors. So with this from this equation 3, okay, the resultant voltage E is given by the vector sum of voltage across R and voltage across C, that is ER and EC. Therefore, I will be adding ER and EC. So ER plus EC is equals to E. We observe here ER plus EC is equals to E, which is equals to I into ZC. Okay, so here I consider ZC as the capacitive impedance of the circuit. So this will represent the phasor diagram for the RC series circuit. The arrow mark shown beside I indicates the assumed positive direction of rotation of vectors is anticlockwise. So with this direction of vectors only, the leading of current is justified. Okay, if I consider the we will not get confused by considering the opposite direction. So that all the vectors are rotating in the anticlockwise direction. So with this direction of rotation, observe current I is on reference axis, whereas voltage E is falling behind current I by an angle phi. It means that voltage is lagging behind current by an angle phi, or I can observe that current is leading voltage by an angle phi. So equation 2 gets justified with this phasor diagram, that current I will be leading voltage E by an angle phi degree. Okay, so from vector diagram, the same vector diagram I have repeated here, okay, where ZC is capacitive impedance, okay, and I is equals to Im sin omega t plus phi. Just now as I explained that current I is leading voltage E. Why I am taking current I? Because voltage E is considered to be having a initial phase angle of 0 degrees. Okay. So therefore I will be defining current I with respect to voltage E. So with respect to voltage E, current I is leading by an angle phi, and with respect to current I, voltage E is lagging behind the current by an angle phi. Therefore I is equals to Im sin omega t plus phi. It indicates, plus phi indicates the leading nature of the quantity. So where Im is given by Em upon Zc, okay, where Zc is the capacitive impedance. If I take the voltage triangle, okay, that is Er, the triangle representing the vectors Er, Ec and E is known as voltage triangle. Okay, so this is the voltage triangle of RC circuit. So Er is in phase with the current I, Ec is lagging behind the current I by an angle 90 degrees, E is the resultant voltage existing at an angle phi with respect to the reference axis lagging. From this voltage triangle, I will consider the impedance triangle where the vector Ir proportionally taken as resistance vector, though resistance is a scalar. All these values are scalar quantities, but why I am consider it to be vector is to establish the phase angle relation between R, Zc and Xc. Okay, I will be slightly deviating from the nature and considering it to be the vector quantities. Okay, so please don't take this impedance triangle as vector. You just consider it to be a triangle with having a sides R, which is base for an angle phi, side Xc, which is the opposite side for an angle phi, and side Zc, which is the hypotenuse of the right angle triangle. Okay, so this gives the impedance triangle of the RC circuit. Okay, so please remember the impedance triangle of RL circuit. Impedance triangle of RC circuit is the vertical flipped version of impedance triangle of RL circuit. Okay, so in further analysis we will see how these two are related. Okay. Therefore capacitive impedance Zc is given by the Pythagoras theorem, under root R square plus Xc square, whereas Xc is the capacitive reactance given by Xc equal to 1 over omega c, or Xc is equal to 1 over 2 pi Fc. Yeah. Now the instantaneous power consumed by the circuit is P is equal to E into I, where from equation 1 and 2 I have the instantaneous equations for voltage and current, where E equal to Em sin omega t and I equal to Im sin omega t plus phi. Now substituting these two equations in P, I can write P is equals to Em sin omega t into Im sin omega t plus phi. Okay. So rewriting the equation for the power, taking Em Im initially, I can write P is equals to Em Im sin omega t into sin omega t plus phi. From this equation, we can see there is a trigonometric relation that sin omega t into sin omega t plus phi. I can conveniently consider sin A into sin B. Okay, so we have some trigonometrical relations and formula for representation of trigonometric functions. Now I will consider this to be sin A into sin B, and we have the formula for sin A into sin B as 1 by 2 cos of A minus B minus cos of A plus B. So from this equation I can write the equation for power. From this relation of sin A sin B, I can write the equation of power in the next form. So P is equals to Em Im will remain as it is. So Em Im into 1 by 2 half, that is there in this formula, 1 by 2 into cos of A minus B. So here A is omega t, B is omega t plus phi. So cos of A minus B will yield omega cos of omega t minus of omega t plus phi. Cos of omega t minus of omega t plus phi. Cos A minus cos B. Okay. sorry, cos A minus B, okay, minus cos of A plus B. So it is minus cos of omega t plus phi. So minus cos of omega t plus phi. Okay. Now we can observe in the first term, omega t minus omega t, it becomes 0. So here I will get Em Im by 2 cos of minus phi minus cos of 2 omega t plus phi. We know that cos of minus theta is cos theta. It is an even function. Therefore, cos of minus phi will be cos phi. So, power consumed is given by Em by 2 cos phi minus Em Im by 2 cos of 2 omega phi. From this equation, P is equals to Em Im by 2 cos phi minus Em Im by 2 cos of 2 omega t plus phi. We have got two terms in this equation of power. So the first term represents Em, Im by 2 cos phi. Now value of Em is fixed because the source voltage or supply voltage is fixed. Value of Im is given by Em upon impedance, and impedance is the combination of resistance and reactance. So as long as my circuit components are constant, my Im will also remain constant. As R and C are remaining constant, my R and XC will remain constant, therefore ZC will remain constant, hence Im equal to Em by ZC is also a constant. So therefore, Em Im by 2 represent a constant value for the given circuit parameters and it is a scalar. Cos phi is a power factor which is equals to R by Z. So cos phi is given by R by Z. So this cos phi is okay, we haven't seen yet the relation what is R by Z. So let us consider cos phi is the cosine of angle between voltage and current. Okay, so unless and until I change the circuit parameters, the phasor relation between voltage and currents will not change. Therefore, for a given constant circuit parameters or the circuit component values, the phasor relation between E and I is constant. Hence, cos phi is also a constant for the given circuit component values. Hence, the entire first term will represent a scalar term. It is a scalar quantity. Whereas the second term, when we observe, it has got a vector quantity of angular velocity twice the supply voltage. So, 2 omega represent a vector that is rotating at an angular velocity twice the supply voltage. Therefore, the second term represents a vector quantity. But we know that the nature, the power is a scalar quantity. Hence, the vector term in the power equation has no meaning in its representation. I can simply discard the vector term and I represent the power consumed by the RC circuit as P is equals to Em Im by 2 cos phi. Okay. So further, I can write Em Im by 2 cos phi as Em by root 2 into Im by root 2 into cos phi. And I know that Em by root 2 is the RMS value of voltage, Im by root 2 is the RMS value of current. Therefore, the power consumed by the RC circuit is given by P is equals to EI cos phi. Now recall, the power consumed by RL circuit was also equals to P equal is equals to EI cos phi. So what I can observe here is, in general, the power consumed in any AC circuit is given by P is equals to EI cos phi. Okay. So P is equals to EI cos phi is the power consumed in any AC circuit where E is the RMS value of supply voltage, I is the RMS value of current flowing through the circuit, and phi is the angle between voltage and current. Okay. So the power waveform is given as, the blue waveform represents the voltage starting at omega t is equals to 0. The red waveform represents the current. See here, current I is starting before voltage E is starting. Okay. So this is 0. Sorry, I just missed a marking here. This is omega t is equals to 0. And this is omega t is equals to phi ahead of 0. Okay, so this can be represented as minus phi actually with respect to the timeline considered here, but that doesn't mean minus is lagging. So physically I can see here, first the current is starting, later the voltage is starting. Okay, see, please don't think that how can a current exist before the voltage exists in the circuit. So when current is existing at an angle phi before 0, it doesn't mean voltage is not existing here. Voltage is existing at phi before 0, but it is getting appeared across capacitor after an angle phi because of the opposition offered by the capacitor. That itself is called the lagging effect of voltage. Okay, so therefore you need not to get confused that how come a current exists before the voltage exists. Okay, so there is no confusion at all with respect to this point. Okay, so voltage will exist with current, but when it appears across capacitor, the voltage will appear across it after some delay. Okay, so therefore I represent the current waveform before the voltage, before the start of voltage waveform. So this red waveform represents the current which is existing before the voltage has started at omega t equals to 0. So see here, the maximum value of voltage is reached at omega t is equals to 90 degrees, whereas maximum value of current is reached before 90 degrees by an angle phi. Voltage waveform completes its one cycle at omega t is equals to 2 pi, whereas current waveform is completing its first cycle before omega t is equals to 2 pi by an angle phi. Okay, so the green waveform represent the power waveform. Okay, so here you can observe from phi to 0, voltage is positive, current is positive, voltage is negative, therefore power will be negative, whereas from 0 to 90 minus phi, both voltage and current are positive, hence power is positive. Again from 180 minus phi to 180, the power is negative because your voltage is positive, current is negative. Okay, and from 180 degrees to 360 degrees minus phi, both voltage and current are negative, therefore power is positive. So this is the waveform of power. Green waveform represents the power. So when you take the average power over the complete cycle, say from existing from minus phi to 360 degrees minus phi, the complete cycle of power, if I take the average power over a complete cycle, the average power comes to be positive. As you can see, the negative pulses are very small and positive pulses are prominent. Therefore, the power consumed by the circuit is positive. It means that the power is flowing from source to the components. It means the components are consuming the power. So what power consumed in the circuit is? Some part of the power is dissipated in the form of heat across R, and some part of the power is stored in the form of electrostatic energy across or electrostatic field across the capacitance. So that is the combination. Okay, so the power consumed is given by P is equals to EI cos phi. So power consumed means what? It is the amount of power that is useful to do any work. So that is P is equals to EI cos phi. Okay, so generally power consumed by any AC circuit is given by P is equals to EI cos phi. So whether it is an RL circuit, whether it is an RC circuit, whether it is combination of RL and C circuit, whether the components RL and C are connected in series, in parallel, in combination of series parallel. So the power consumed in an single phase AC circuit is always given by P equal to EI cos phi, whereas E is the supply voltage, I is the resultant current, RMS resultant current, whereas phi is the angle between the supply voltage and resultant current in the circuit. So there is no question of resultant current in series circuit, but there is resultant voltage. Okay, whereas if it is parallel combination, it will be resultant current and voltage will remain common across each component. If there is a series parallel combination, there will be resultant voltages, resultant currents. So therefore phi represents the angle between the resultant voltage and the resultant current in general. Therefore, the power consumed by the circuit, a AC circuit, is given by P equals to EI cos phi. So from the impedance triangle, I can write, now I will be defining what is cos phi. So from impedance triangle, I can write cos phi, power factor cos phi is equals to, from very fundamental definition of cos function, it is adjacent upon hypotenuse. So it will be R by ZC. Z or ZC, both are same. So cos phi is equals to R by Z. Whereas phi is given by, I can write a tan phi is equals to opposite upon base. Okay. So whereas phi is given by tan inverse of XC by R. Okay. So remember, again RL circuit, the power factor in RL circuit was given by R by ZL, where it Z represented there the inductive impedance, and phi was given by tan inverse of XL by R, where XL was the capacitive reactance. Okay. So in general, I can write power factor is always the ratio of resistance to impedance of the circuit, and power factor angle is always tan inverse of ratio of reactance to resistance of the circuit. Okay. So we have the equation 1 and 2. From equation 1 and 2, E equal to m sin omega t is at reference, I equal to im sin omega t is leading voltage E by an angle 90 degrees. With respect to equation 1 and 2, I will draw the vectors of E and I. So we can observe vector I is at an angle phi leading with respect to E. I can have the components of vector I, vertical component and horizontal component. So I can resolve vector I into two vectors representing vertical component and horizontal component. So vertical component, okay, is represented as I sin phi. Horizontal component is represented as I cos phi. Simple. It is a right angle triangle. You can simply say that the base function is defined with respect to the cos function. Base side is defined with respect to cos function, and opposite side is defined with respect to sine function. Okay. So therefore, horizontal component, which is base for the triangle, is I cos phi, and vertical component, which is opposite side, is I sin phi. So from this, I will take this triangle, okay, the current triangle, and see what happens. So current I is the hypotenuse, I cos phi is the base, I sin phi is the opposite side. So from this vector, okay, triangle, we can see I cos phi is the component of the current that will fall in phase with the voltage. I sin phi is the component of the current that is leading the voltage. Okay. So we know that I cos phi is the in phase current with voltage, therefore that is effectively the current that is creating the power dissipation in the circuit or power consumption in the circuit. Why? Because power consumption occurs only in resistive part, okay, or in the resistance part, and across resistance the voltage and current are always in phase. So the component that will fall in phase with the voltage in any circuit is the current that is responsible for power consumption in the circuit. Therefore, in the equation of power, it is P equal to EI cos phi. Okay? When you see the power, I is equals to E into I in general. Okay? So I represents the current that is responsible for power consumption. So in an AC circuit with the reactive components in the circuit, the component of the current that falls in phase with the voltage is the current that is responsible for power consumption. Therefore, we consider P equal to EI cos phi. Though mathematically it is proved that P equal to EI cos phi, the interpretation of that equation physically is that I cos phi is the component of the current that is responsible for the power consumption in the circuit, because that is effectively the current across the resistance. Okay. Therefore, I cos phi is known as the active component or real component of the current, whereas I sin phi is the current that is existing at an angle 90 degree in quadrature with the voltage E, and that always create or that is always responsible for energy storing in the circuit. Okay, in the previous section, RL circuit, we have discussed that I sin phi is responsible for magnetizing the circuit or storing energy in the form of electromagnetic field. But here in RC circuit, I sin phi is responsible for charging of capacitor. That is, I sin phi is the component of current that is responsible for creating a electrostatic energy in the circuit. Though again it is the current that is responsible for energy storage. Capacitor stores energy in the form of electrostatic field, so I sin phi is responsible for that storage of energy. So therefore I sin phi is known as reactive component of the current, because I sin phi is existing because of reactive nature of the circuit. Hence it is known as reactive component or wattless component. Why it is called wattless is because this I sin phi is not contributing for any power consumption, unlike I cos phi. Okay, so I cos phi is contributing for power consumption, so I can call that as wattful component, whereas I sin phi is not contributing for any power consumption, hence it is called as wattless component. Okay, and I is the total current or apparent current in the circuit. Now if I multiply voltages to each current, okay, then I get a power triangle. Okay, if I simply multiply E to I cos phi and E to I sin phi, I get the power triangle. So this is called power triangle. So I can observe there are three different powers. This already we have discussed in RL section previously. Again I will be repeating this. So these three powers, EI cos phi and EI sin phi, are defined as, whereas EI cos phi is defined as, see, EI cos phi is existing because of the component I cos phi. Therefore, as active component of the current is creating a power EI cos phi, this is called active power or real power or power consumed. This already we have proved just now, P equal to EI cos phi. So therefore, it is called active component or active power or real power or power consumed. So this is measured in watts. The unit of power consumed or active power is in watts. So this EI cos phi is the amount of power that is being consumed by the circuit to do some work. So for example, if I consider, if you observe various electrical devices or appliances rated with the power values in watts, okay, never you observe the power rating of the electrical devices in our especially domestic applications with the power rating other than watts. Okay, you don't observe in reactive volt amperes or volt amperes. So generally when you see any lamp, it is, if you take a LED lamp, it is rated as 9 watts or so. If you take the heater, water heater, immersion heater, it will be 1 kilowatt or 2 kilowatt. If you take iron box, it is 1 kilowatt or 2 kilowatt. If you take hair dryer, it is 1 or 1.5 kilowatt. If you take fan, some 70 to 80 watts. So every electrical appliance is rated in watts. It means that is the amount of power consumed by that device to do the work. So to do the work, in the sense, the work of fan is to create mechanical energy. The work of iron box is to create heat energy. The work of lamp is to create light energy. Okay, or to give light energy. So that much amount of power is consumed to give their specific outcome, output of the devices. And that is EI cos phi. Okay, so that is EI cos. So EI cos phi is the wattage rating of the every appliance. Okay, whereas EI sin phi is because of the reactive component of the current. Hence it is known as reactive power or wattless power. Okay, so this reactive power is existing across the reactive components. In this case, across capacitor. In previous case, across inductor. And if capacitance and inductance both are present, it is present across both. Okay, but in opposite direction. We'll see in the next forthcoming lectures how the reactive components are opposing each other. Okay, so this is called EI sin phi, the reactive power or wattless power. Okay, so this power is responsible for creating the energy storing in the circuit. Okay, though it is not contributing for any work done, but this power is still necessary for me to exist in the system, so that the energy storing components can operate with this power. If I make this power zero, then energy storage components will not store any energy. Okay? So there are many applications of windings where it is an RL circuit. If the winding do not create flux, then the electromagnetic components will not operate. My motors, generators will not operate. Okay, so to create flux, I need EI sin phi there in RL circuit. So to create electrostatic energy, I need EI sin phi in RC circuit. So this, though EI sin phi is not contributing for any power consumption or work done, this is necessary for me to have the energy storing phenomena in the circuit. Okay, whereas EI is given by the total power or apparent power, which is measured in volt amperes. Reactive power is measured in volt amperes reactive or a reactive volt amperes. Okay. So generally, from this power triangle, I can give cos phi power factor is equals to active power by apparent power. So in any AC circuit, certain definitions are now fixed. Okay, that is, the current is the ratio of voltage to impedance. The power factor is the angle between resultant voltage and resultant current. Power factor is also the ratio of resistance to impedance. And power factor angle or phase angle is the tan inverse of ratio of resistance to reactance to resistance. Or I can also write power factor cos phi is equals to active power, ratio of active power to apparent power. So this is all about the RC circuit. Okay, the fundamental understanding of RC circuit. I hope you got it. In the next lecture, we will be dealing with the RLC series circuit, and after that we will go deal with the representation of impedances in various forms and parallel circuits and the numericals. So this is all about the RC circuit. RL circuit has already been discussed in the previous lecture. In the next lecture, we'll discuss RLC series circuit. Okay. So thank you.